Hello, and welcome to OSA's Imaging and Applied Optics Congress in San Francisco, California. I'm here with Dr. Mohan Trivedi from UC San Diego. Sir, thank you for joining us today. Your presentation spoke about robotic automative cohabitation in automobiles. Can you tell us a bit more about your plenary today?
Sure. First of all, thank you so much for inviting me. And the basic thrust of our research is that we are very excited about the changes which are happening in the mobility field, where vehicles are really becoming robotic and very intelligent. But at the same time, we want to make sure that they are safe, and they are those which are going to be comfortable for humans who are either sitting in it, who are moving around it, who are going to cross next to them. And to do that, we really think of a future where for engineers like us and computer scientists, when we are developing new types of systems, we really look at a team of intelligent agents. Some of them are biological, like you and me, and some of them are artificial, like the robotic vehicles. But in order to really have this thing work out comfortably, efficiently, and more importantly, safely, they need to choreograph their dances so that both parties are going to be comfortable and they are understanding each other. And that's basically what we talked about.
Perfect, thank you. And there's obviously a lot of optics that are enabling those next generation technologies. Can you tell us more about those?
Yes, without optics, none of this will happen. So one of the key things that we need to do when we are developing these intelligent, safe, robotic systems for humans to use is for us to really sense the environment in which these robots are going to operate. And sensors are more often than not are optical sensors, be radars or LIDARs or cameras. And they all need to be good enough, robust enough for us to capture what is in the surround. But also, as I was mentioning, that there are going to be people who are going to be sitting in the car and they are going to react if you are going to make a hard brake or if you are going to do something which is very slow or if you are going to do something which is going to be really very risky. And then you want to look at the comfort effects that people are going to show. Are they surprised? Are they really scared? Or they are comfortable and minding their own business as the robots are doing their things? And those are also going to be optical sensors. So without sensing this whole loop of perception, planning, and action that we have to do cannot happen. So optics is at the foundation.
And the optical industry field is growing. So as for new career professionals interested in going into this industry, what piece of advice could you offer them?
Oh, come and join the big party. I think it's really an exciting time. There are a lot of barriers which used to be there in the past, mainly I think the computational cost, the things related to cost of the hardware, as well as the quality of the hardware, sensors and all, that has really become very affordable and easy to reach. But fundamentally the issue is not that can we sense something or not, but can we analyze and interpret a risk versus something which is really risk-free. Something which is going to indicate that these are the things that you should do or you shouldn't do. Something which is going to quantify whether your safety metrics are properly defined or not. Whether a failure of a sensor, how does that affect the failure of the computational algorithm? All of those are open research areas, and we hope that bright young people will make their careers so that we will really live in a world which is going to be more enjoyable, more comfortable, more efficient, and safe. So a lot of wonderful things to work on, and I'm really always telling young people that it's quite common for you to probably find a career where you would have enjoyable life, that you can play, develop video games, you can develop something which is going to be in educational things and all that, many nice things which you can do. But here is a field where I will almost guarantee that you might get a satisfaction that you are saving somebody's life. And that doesn't happen that often And now is the time for us to really do these things where you know how many accidents happen on the roads. And now it is becoming possible for us to develop new age technological systems where optics, sensing, computing, pattern recognition, computer vision type of experts would really reduce the risks which are in everyday life.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time today. Signing off from OSA's Imaging and Applied Optics Congress in San Francisco.